watching Time Warner Cable News New York 1 all day.
The Firefighters Union and the city strike a new contract deal. Our Dean Meminger is at City Hall with details on that. Dean?
Yeah, it was a long, hard-fought battle between the fire union and City Hall, but they announced today, yes, they do have a new agreement that stretches over 7 years, and it's an 11% increase for those firefighters, and it's a retroactive deal. Now, standing with the mayor and other administrators, the union stood there proudly saying, you know what, this is a good deal for their 8,000 firefighters, and they are happy that they received it. It's not only an increase for the firefighters, but also newer firefighters will now have disability funding similar to older firefighters, where they will have enough if they get injured on the job. There are also some other benefits where firehouses will now be able to have more firefighters. Here's the mayor and the head of the firefighters union.
There has been an atmosphere of respect and communication, even when there's disagreements, and I want people to understand that. You can disagree on any particular issue and still keep talking. You can disagree in any given moment and still recognize the many things that bind us together. I can safely say that the City of New York and all of my colleagues here, we never stopped talking to Steve and the other leaders of the UFA.
I believe that my members will ratify this contract, even though they may not be happy with the total deal, because firefighters believe that we should be paid a little more. But having said what's happened in patterns, the teachers took a pattern deal, then the Uniform Coalition took a pattern deal, and then we took a deal that we were able to, with some money in the middle of it, move some numbers around, and I think we got the best deal possible.
Now, as you heard the union say that this deal needs to be ratified by the 8,000 firefighters, once again, it is an 11% raise over 7 years, retroactive to 2010. Now, the only other major union that doesn't have a contract deal yet, the police union, the PBA, the mayor says they are welcome to sit down at the table. They are currently in arbitrations between the police union and City Hall over their union deal or a lack of a contract. That is the very latest at City Hall. Dean Meminger, New York One. Let's go back to you in the newsroom.
Thank you, Dean.
We're back inside City Hall, and as we reported earlier, the union representing city firefighters agreed to terms on a new contract today with the de Blasio administration. The deal resolves longstanding concerns over disability pay, plus the union is dropping a lawsuit against City Council Speaker Melissa Mark Viverito. That was over a controversial vote on that issue. Joining me now to talk about today's news is Steve Cassidy, the president of the Uniform Firefighters Association. Thanks for coming in and congratulations.
Thank you, Errol.
I know you've been working on this for a long, long time. Let's get some of the details out of the way. Is this different from other uniform services? The city says this is pretty much within the pattern.
Well, it's the same seven-year contract, 11% during that 7 years. Part of our deal was we were able to get a credit on roster staffing, an agreement that we had that's been expired a long time. From that, we got 25-man engine companies to be phased in over a few years. And we got a credit that allowed us to move money within the previous pattern that allowed us to get 1% on day one. So we think we did really well on that, including the agreement on disability benefits to restore that for new firefighters hired after 2009. And we thought this was a deal we could not pass up.
Let's talk about the disability, because you generated quite a lot of news and a lot of heat, political heat around that. What was the final outcome? What you were trying to do was get back to the old, I think, tier two sort of standard, where if you retired on disability, you would get three quarters pay.
Yes. We wanted full restoration of tier two disability benefits, which would be three quarters if you're permanently disabled on the line of duty. Including in tier two was the presumptive bills, heart, lung, cancer that firefighters have earned over the years. And if a young firefighter were to get sick with those currently, he wouldn't be covered. So we got a restoration of tier two disability benefits with full presumptions. The agreement was, and the mayor didn't want to give that to us earlier.
Yes.
He agreed to that. We agreed to have our new members pay 3% more into the pension. So instead of paying 3, they're now paying 6. We think it's a good deal for us. It's certainly something our members will like.
And so the scenario that you talked about on this program before, that, God forbid, a young firefighter comes on the job, if in the line of duty, or because, as you say, presumed, if they get certain kind of disability, it's just assumed that they got it on the job, smoke inhalation or something like that, bad back, they'll be taken care of?
That's correct, and this was something that I thought was a mandate for the union to solve. I said that we couldn't have any firefighters getting off a fire truck, running into a burning building and say, what happens to my family if I get hurt today? They need to be focused on the job. It's a dangerous, challenging job. Us taking care of this today will solve that problem for all firefighters. Nobody will have to worry about anything but doing their job.
You're dropping the lawsuit against the city council. You were trying to sort of get to the bottom of how one of the bills, the home rule bill that you wanted to get passed so that this whole question, this disability question, could go to Albany. You were trying to get to the bottom of why it got killed. You've decided to drop that. Why?
Well, we agreed to drop it as part of this, and that was our foil lawsuit. We wanted to know who allegedly filed this paperwork ahead of Elizabeth Crowley. Since we have an agreement, we have to go to the council and get a home rule. The mayor asked me to drop this lawsuit against the speaker. I said I would do it. Mm-hmm. I'm happy to do it. I want to have a better relationship with the council. I think we proved our point anyway. But more importantly, we're about going forward. What happened in the past is done. We have a bill. We want to get it ratified. And we're going to work together.
Does this resolve the disability issue for the balance of for the life of the contract, or
forever?
Will you be going back to Albany?
We have to go to Albany. Mm-hmm. We got to get a home rule from the council, go to Albany arm in arm with the mayor, get the assembly and the Senate to pass it, and of course get the governor to sign it. We believe we will do that. We have already reached out to all the key principals. We don't anticipate any problems. Arm in arm, there has never been a problem in the past when a union and the administration agree on a bill.
Uh-huh. So this issue is done, and there won't be any more back and forth with the council on that particular issue?
No, we think it's going to be done. It may take us till January, but we think it will be done and settled forever, and then every firefighter currently on the job can opt in, the 1,700, and all future firefighters will automatically be in a new pension system that has full disability benefits, which is what we wanted.
Okay, very good. We're going to leave it there for now. Congratulations. Thanks for coming by to explain it to us.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to take a short break now.